Chapter 23. It was time for the Schnells to leave. Oki forced herself to smile as she went into the girls' rooms.
Ohayo gozaimasu, Francis Chan and Mary Chan.
Ohayo go,
said Francis, and then she reached up to Oki's face and brushed a finger along her cheek where a tear had escaped. She looked into Oki's eyes and said softly,
Oki?
It is all right, Francis Chan. I will not be able to go with you today.
No, Oki, you must come with us, said Francis.
Oki tried to smile as she took two red origami birds out of her sleeve and gave them to the girls.
Here is a gift for each of you, for you to remember me. Look closely at the paper birds. The little finch has given you a gift, too. Do you recognize the feather next to the bird's heart?
The girls nodded their heads.
I am not well enough to go with you, but I will wait here until you return. I love you both so much, and I will miss you.
Mary clung to Oki, first looking at Francis, then at her nanny, and then she started to cry. Oki hugged both girls, trying to keep sad thoughts away. She mustered all of her strength, took the girls' hands, and led them outside. It was time to go. Mrs. Schnell looked sad also. She had already said goodbye to Oki, and now there was nothing more to say. Kuninosuke would be in charge of the farm. Herr Schnell had announced to the colonists this would be so. Herr Schnell stood by the wagon, waiting for his family. He looked at all the Japanese workers who were there to see him off, hope in their eyes. He spoke slowly and not in his usual loud voice.
I will come back, he promised, before 3 months have passed. I will be standing in this yard again. I will not say sayonara, for I will return as soon as I can.
His voice shook, and he did not continue. He turned to his wife. Jo-san, we must leave now. He helped her climb into the wagon, took the girls from Oki, and lifted them into the back of the wagon. He climbed up onto the buckboard, looked straight ahead, and picked up the reins.
Papa-san, wait, said Frances.
And she held her doll out to Oki and said,
Oki, please, this is my gift for you. I love you, Oki.
As Herr Schnell drove away from the farmhouse, the girls called out,
Oki, we love you.
They called again and again until they disappeared around the curve. Oki watched the wagon leave, taking with it the most important people in her life.
I love you too, she whispered.
She held the little doll close to her heart, and tears came. Matsu stood beside her. Matsu, the samurai, strong and dependable, who could do nothing to help her now. They were still standing in front of the house when a wagon pulled up. At first, Oki thought it was Herr Schnell, but it was only Henry.
Hey, you two, he called out as he reined in the horse. My mother almost had a heart attack when she saw Herr Schnell go past our house. She saw that you weren't in the wagon, Oki, and she told me to fetch you both. I'm taking you home to our house.
Oki just stared at him. She was exhausted and confused. What was he saying? So much had happened today, so much sadness. She did not understand him.
Come on, Oki. Mother's got the soup on the stove and the pies are in the oven. Hurry up, Matsu, before my brothers get to them.
Matsu looked at Oki and smiled. Come, Oki. Henry's mother wants us to stay with them until Schnell-san returns. She will not take no for an answer. They went into the house to collect their belongings. Matsu helped Oki climb into the wagon. She could hardly see where she was going. She was blinded by the steady flow of tears, and she did nothing to stop them. When the three friends were finally settled, Henry flicked the reins, and the horse slowly pulled the wagon away from the Wakamatsu tea and silk farm.